And lastly, you want to connect your camera, of course, to the Mac using the USB. And lastly, you want it, which side of the camera is it? Well, hi everyone, and welcome to Pal to Tech. Great news for all you Mac users. Fujifilm has released their new X Webcam software for the Mac. Previously, it was only available for Windows, but now they have two different versions. Fuji's new webcam software basically hooks into the tethering capabilities of the Fujifilm cameras and makes your Mac recognize this as a webcam without the need for third-party video capture devices such as the Cam Link. The software itself will support Macs running the latest versions of Catalina, Mojave, High Sierra, and even Sierra. The supported Fujifilm cameras that will work with this are the GFX series, the X-H1, the X-Pro2, the X-Pro3, and of course the X-T2, X-T3, and X-T4. I should mention that if you already have a Fujifilm X-A7 or X-T200, then you've already got webcam ability built right into the camera. You don't need this new standalone Mac webcam software. But for the rest of us, let's get started and take it on a spin. So the first thing you need to do is go to the download page. I will have a link to that in the description of this video right down below. Once you get there, choose Mac if you don't already see it there. Then scroll down, agree, and click on download. That will download the package file to your computer. Simply click on it to open it up. Once it's installed, you will need to restart your computer. Now that you have the software installed, you're going to need to set up your camera. Do this before you connect your camera to your Mac. If you have an X-T4, be sure that you put it into still mode before you begin. You want to put your drive on S for single frame. Next, you want to go into your camera menu settings and set it to USB tether shooting auto. Go into the wrench, select connection setting, go down to connection mode and choose USB tether shooting auto. Don't forget to put it back to USB card reader when you're all finished using it as a webcam. Now, those are the basic settings you have to make before you can connect your camera to the Mac. However, Fujifilm does have a few additional recommendations. The first, go into AF/MF onto page 2 and make sure that AF/MF is turned on. And next, go into AF/MF face eye detection setting and go ahead and put face detection to on. I also actually like to set eye to auto as well. There are more recommendations and coverage of the whole setup provided by Fuji. I'll have a link to all of those resources down below in the description of this video as well. What I'm going to do before starting this demo is set the exposure modes to automatic everything. Automatic ISO, automatic shutter speed, and automatic aperture. And finally, you need to connect your Fujifilm camera to your Mac with a USB cable, just like that. Then make sure you have all your settings set first. I can't emphasize that enough. And lastly, turn on the camera. So to do this demonstration, I'm going to open up Zoom, which is a popular meeting app. In Zoom, you go into your video settings and you'll see your list of cameras. Right now, it's defaulting to the built-in camera on the MacBook. Simply change that selection to Fujifilm X Webcam and you should see it appear. Okay, so what I need to do is zoom out a little bit. There we go. Oh, hey, not too bad, not too bad. Okay, maybe move this down a bit. Okay, all right. Hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. Okay, so this is a test to see how I look on the Fujifilm camera compared to how I look on the built-in webcam. Here's an example of what it looks like with bad lighting. Even though I'm using the Fujifilm camera, it doesn't look that good. Now I'm gonna switch over to the Mac camera, and the only thing I'm gonna change is I'm gonna add better lighting. Okay, so here I am with better lighting. As you can see, that actually makes more of a difference than having a high-end camera with a high-end lens to do your webcasting. By the way, if you happen to see this message appear where it just shows the logo for the Fujifilm X webcam, that most likely means your camera is either not on or your Mac is not recognizing the camera. And the most common cause of this problem would be your USB cable. If you're seeing this image, you have the software installed correctly. It's just a matter of having the camera connected to the Mac with the correct USB cable. Something to consider is audio, of course. Now, if you go into your audio settings of Zoom or whatever software you're using, you will see that there is generally an area where you can choose your audio source. In this case, it's coming from the MacBook Pro microphone. There is no ability to record audio from the built-in microphone on the Fujifilm camera. You're going to have to use either the audio that's built in, the mic that's built in on your Mac, or what I think is a better solution is to connect a third-party mic like a lav mic to your Mac or to your computer, because you're going to get better audio that way. So you take basically a lav mic, you clip a lav mic on yourself, then you run it into your Mac. Generally, they have a USB-based lav mic. It's not a great one, but it does the job, and it gives you much better audio than you'll get if your camera's further away. Remember, with good audio, you want to be as close as possible to where you're speaking. That will make a huge difference to the professionalism of your videos. I'll have a link below to where you can get one of these little lav mics. In the meantime, let's wrap this up and talk about a few things. Okay, first off, I think it's great that Fujifilm listened to their customers and released a Mac version of this software fairly soon after they did the Windows one. Now, a couple of issues that I do have with it. Because it basically functions in tethered mode, you can't adjust the exposure triangle once the camera is turned on and connected to the Mac, meaning you have to turn off the camera, adjust the exposure, and then turn the camera back on, rinse and repeat. So that's one problem, I would say. However, you can put the camera in auto everything and then don't have to worry about it, as long as you have consistent lighting conditions where you happen to be shooting. And this goes the same with the film simulations. Make sure you set them before you connect your camera to the Mac. Another limitation of the software is that it does not support OBS. Now, there is a workaround to that, and you can Google, OBS Fujifilm camera support to find it. However, it, for me personally, it's a little too much effort. And lastly, keep in mind that you cannot connect even an external microphone to the Fujifilm camera and run your audio from there. You need to use a microphone connected directly to the Mac. With regard to latency problems, I really didn't notice any in my testing, although I will admit today was the first day it was released, and I have not really tested this a whole lot. However, even with the limitations of this new software, I think it's great that they have it. I plan on using it myself from time to time. But remember something though, it's not about the quality of the camera and the lens that matters when it comes to online webcam type videos. Far more important than what camera you're using is the quality of your lighting, your audio, and the way that you frame the shot, what you have in the background, how close you are to the back, you know all that stuff. The point is, I notice in a lot of YouTube videos and elsewhere that everyone's emphasizing having the biggest and the best and the most expensive and the greatest lens and highest quality camera for your webcam. And quite honestly, you can do a hell of a lot even with a phone, or even with the crummy little cam that comes with your laptop. You can do a hell of a lot with that if you have good lighting and good sound. So work on those first. In the meantime, try this out, download it, test it out. I think that if you have a Fujifilm supported camera, you're going to love using it. It was real easy. It worked flawlessly in all my testing. Well, that does it for me today. I will see you tomorrow on a Fast Friday episode, and then all next week in brand new videos. Viltrox! Excuse me. If you like this video, please click on the like and subscribe, and I will see you soon. Take care. And lastly, you want to connect your camera, of course, to the Mac using the USB. And lastly, you want it, which side of the camera? And lastly, you want to connect the camera, of course, to the MacBook. Blah, blah, blah. And lastly, you need to connect the MacBook. I can't take it anymore. And lastly, you need to And lastly, you need to connect your Fujifilm camera to your Mac computer with a USB cable. Just like this. What the f*** with this? Not the right cord. That's why. And finally, you need to connect your Fujifilm camera to your Mac using a USB cable.